Yeah, so it's all clear. It's all... What's that? No, I told him, shut his mouth. Don't get in the road. Don't get in the road. I said to him, you look after the taumata, and the taumata is just the taumata in the marae, and this is not your marae. This is Kingi's marae on his land, so he can talk. You're from Matari Bay. And he says, he's in the whakamininga. I says, yeah, well, that's the whakamininga. That's an entity, another entity. But the Confederation is another entity. It's different things for different things. See? I'm too wise for them. If they try and... what Hohepa sees is the money in it that's involved if we get this thing through with the flag up. He went and jumped in the last time on the 15th. Of April, I went and got the marae. The Waitangi National Trust gave me the marae to go in. They just said, John, we can't stop you. We've seen enough. You can do what you like. So we went in there, and Hoipa got in the way, and he told me, don't put the flag up. And Kingi got upset, and then that stuffed that lot, and then he brought the police in, just in case there was trouble. Hohepa. He brought the police in. One police, Paul Tipene. He's from Kerikeri. Constable, brought the constable. It's just as well he came because he was shocked at what I was talking about and at the history that's been sort of like hidden in what was going on in that marae, eh? Well, the thing is, Hohepa brought him in because that's his mate. And Hohepa was trying to, run things himself and say, we're at the learning, the incubator stage to me, and saying, you Arataki's, you need to learn what to do. And I says, I beg your pardon. Do you know anything about this flag and what it does? He says, he's got the history where it came from. I just said, well, that's where it came from. What about the rest of it? What do you think? It's just for home here or around the world or anywhere or England or where? And so he couldn't answer that. I said, I think you look after the taumata and stay there and don't interfere with politics or contracts. If you don't know this, don't go near it because you get in trouble. So Kingi got really, really upset at the flag not going up when we were going to put it up. That's after Korora Reka was the 10th of April, 1834. They had their celebrations. I went there to Korora Reka and we put the flag up, upside down. That's what Jim Wikatu put it upside down. So this time he'll put it up the right way up on the treaty ground. And that time we didn't go. Hohepa said the flag went up on the treaty grounds. That time Maura Hoffman was with you and me up there, and we didn't go to the dawn parade on treaty grounds. Yeah, well, they put the flag up, our flag up, but it should have stayed up, but then it didn't. The itinerary, the 26th is just to talk about the whakamininga, the normal things, but I've got to do a presentation on what's going down on the 28th, and then what everybody else is going to say or do there. But I've limited the time on who speaks on the marae and on the Waitangi marae because I've hired it, I've got it, and I told them that nobody's going to talk out of place because they'll just burn out the time. And it's got to stay open after that for the public. We're not going to upset the running of the business there. We just don't go near anything to upset the public and the government, because at the moment they're going along with what I'm saying. It's a big thing to organise. And I'm talking from a British end. I've got the other end sorted out. No, they're not in it. They're going to get a bill from us after that, from me. they're getting the bill from me from that marae because we already opened it up for business, for debtor business. I've done all the legal work already, and my barrister went against me in the end. But he went on the Crown side, and left me for dead. So now I'm going to string them all up behind the Cook Street case. From that Marae King's Bench Court. I'm treating it as a court, and that will extend to all the other district courts in the country, or any court in the world. Yeah, it has. Kingi knows. Kingi knows, but it's online. I've done a lot of work online so that people know. It's exposed, like what's happening with Hillary Clinton, and they're getting caught over there now. It's good. They're going to, Donkey will get caught here. It'll just default right through the world where the Queen has gone, including the Queen. She's in the EU Parliament, conflict to us. Yeah. I don't know. When the marae will open, it'll open like normal. And Kingi said it'll be open on the 26th, 27th. So long as if you're coming up any time during the day, it's all right. It doesn't matter. All the talking will be in the afternoon anyway at night on the 26th. But the 27th will be the day we'll be going through a lot of our intentions and your proclamation. I'm putting a proclamation that when the captain of the ship of that Admiralty landed in Kororareka, he said this, and he said, and they said this at Waitangi, the land belongs to the king. No, we proclaim the land belongs to the King of England. And so now I'm going to proclaim, and Kingi will proclaim, the land belongs to the chiefs and not the king, right? No, nothing to do with the queen. She's going to get hung by me. I'm going there to hang her. I'm telling you, everybody. I'm going to England. When I get there, I'm going to hang her with King William's acts. I'm using King William's acts of Parliament from 1830 to 1837 in the Maui Crown, Commonwealth Government of the World. That's the New World Order. That's the Pope's. I'm taking over the Pope's title back to King William. And his successor, King Ernest Augustus, is alive in England. He's the King of Britain. So he gets when I get there, I put him in Westminster. I'm doing all that. They're waiting for me in England to go and take him in there, into Westminster. So put the flag up over here and go to England with Kingi and put it up over there. Him and I will go there and put it up. That's it. That's the end of it. No big deal. So, we're stipulating in documents to Britain that it's the British that will stop them from doing anything. You see, I've written to the British government. This is particularly, specifically British. I'm making Kingi fit his role as the chief here and the king over there. I'm just like what the captain of the ship did, came here and proclaimed it belongs to the king. And so I'm proclaiming here that the land belongs to the chiefs, not the king. See? Then go over there and say over there, the chiefs are here now to put the flag up and we're in business. It's in the contract. We're continuing with the contract, or we change the contract over there. Yeah, so that's how it's up to the British. Once we legalise on that day, the British gets the notice after that, straight away, that it's official. And that's why I wanted the Navy there. I'm not dicking around with the Navy. They know what their intention is, and they can't back out of it because everybody knows. I'll make sure that we're going to put it up. So they couldn't stop Wikotu putting the flag up on treaty grounds and up Kororareka. They couldn't stop them. No, well, I'm yet to see that yet, but I'm being diplomatic with my documents. because they're sealed documents of the king. I'm being diplomatic from Kingi's point of view on that land block. It's the land that the ship is landed on. That land is I'm telling Kingi, you proclaim your land back inside that whare, because they do, John Key does all his business inside that whare. You see? It's just a document thing. As long as they got a Maori, Pita Paraoni, he gives consent to the government as iwi, not hapu.
So he's
going to
make a proclamation?
Yeah, here in Maori, yeah, a proclamation that the land belongs to his chiefs, not the king of England. See?
No. He's
going to
make the proclamation.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we need to write it all out.
No, I've already written it all out, ready to go. I've already got it online. Everybody's reading it. I've got the agenda and what King has got to say. He's got to follow what I say, because people are starting to believe what I'm saying now, the surrogate king, King William. I'm standing in for the king. I'm speaking for the king and nobody else has. So I'm a surrogate like the captain on a ship. Like what they did when they came here. No, they have. They still have. That's what Obama's doing, shooting everybody up with King William title. Nobody knows that. They're not kings. They're not male. Male do a male thing. Obama gets it from the queen. The queen has given the king's power to everybody else. The Vatican, she's given the woman in a queen is bad because it sells the land. The king doesn't. The king's getting his land back into his king's bench court from the queen's bench court. No. No, it came straight from King William, straight to Kororareka. That's the first contract title, the real estate land title. I've got all the documents. Nobody's got them. I've got them from Mohi Manukau and Hare Ututaonga. They were the Confederation then. Mohi started that up in 1985, before. Mohi Manukau started the Confederation off in 1985, before the 86 Constitution. He did that to stop the Constitution. The 1852 Constitution changed in 1986, and Mohi started it up. I've got all the documents here. I've got all his okay to do what I do. That's why they can't stop me. No one can stop me because I've got the Manukau titles of Scotland. The original titles here came from Britain. They seized all the New South Wales titles, John Key, and then reissued them again. The British reissued the titles in 1868, and then they became a British title. That's why it's still British here, in America, and Canada. It's still British. The Queen owns America, see? Because she's using Queen Victoria's titles, but Queen Victoria's King William's niece. So they still land up on King William. Where the hell did you get the title from? That's what I say to them. Where did you get your title from? And they give up now because they have no title. I'm holding the title here, the original title with one house on in Waitangi. And No, you have to have a British title because it's a money thing. It's only about money, nothing else. It's just commerce. You have to have banking, commerce, contracts to step on a piece of land and use a document. They've made all the laws here for themselves. There's no laws, no government for Maori, no government, so you can't do what they do. I've got a Moai, Crown, King William, Commonwealth Government of the World running now. It's running around the world now in 250 countries. That's another government. That's your Maori government is on the land here. I'm going around the world with this flag and the New World Order, the Pope's New World Order. So I'm using those titles.
They have to have
Yeah, because it's hopeless having no government. And it's too hard because there's too many people living here now with different titles, international titles, agreements and everything stuck to the land. It's too hard a job to go and kick them all off. You're a bullet in your head from Obama. They're coming here, the Navy's coming here, and don't be surprised there'll be black seal people with guns running around here before long. Just the New World Order stepping in here. That nobody was looking at the New World Order, what the Pope was doing. What's happening in Britain, America, Russia. They're all ready for nuclear war now. That's what I'm preparing for. I'm preparing for this war that could happen any time now with Russia and America announcing today the war's on. No, waste of time. They won't listen to what we say. It's a waste of time because it's nothing to do. Just remember, Admiralty and that flag is a private contract, nobody's business. That's why Obama uses it and John Key uses it, private businesses. The police got their own private businesses. You can't go and inquire into it. The Queen uses private business. You can't go into the Queen's business because it's private. They're using the King's private contract. Yeah, that's why I went into court and the judge threw it out because they said, where's your queen? You got no queen above your head. And yet she's there. And so he dismissed it. He threw the court out, threw the case out for all those marshals that got arrested. They all got off and they don't know what got them off. The judge just cleared them all at the same time. They let me out of court. They didn't let me go into court because I was going there to shut it. I was going into to shut it because I knew they had no jurisdiction, no title, no seals. The police documents they'd arrested me had no seals of anything. They just made it up. The police made it up. That's why they lost, because insufficient evidence from the case. And they put me off so that I wouldn't go to court. Because they were reading it online, what I was going to do to them, shut them up. And I can go and shut down the Waitangi at the same time. Anything at the moment, because the flag is starting to do something. Once we got it legal. Now, I've been respecting them from a point of letting me have the marae. You see, I had to be nice to them and write to them properly and talk to them properly. Well, Ngāpuhi was upset with Kingi too, but for me, he's done the right thing. Because John Key signed the TPPA without coming to check first. Because they have to come into the Te Ti Marae before they can go on the other side and do the other marae. Once they come through the gate on Te Ti Marae, they've got consent to go do what they like on the other side. Yeah, they have to always come into Te Ti to get permission before they go in on an official day to go on the outside. So what we're doing, I said to Kingi, I'll tell you what, Kingi, we go over there and seize the ship, take over the ship of Admiralty, and go in the marae and do what they do to us, to them, right? We go in there and do what they've been doing to us for years. Yeah, and it might be their marae, but it's not their carvings. It's not their flagpole. The British and us own their flagpole. It's a ship. It's supposed to be a ship, but that's where they get their authority from, Britain, straight to their flag staff. See? You see? And John Key was going to throw the flag away and put his fern flag up there so that he could take that mast and everything. He would have if the public went. Yeah, he would have if he got his own flag up there. Oh, no, you've got to write to them. You've got to have a letter that stacks up. You've got to have a documents, that legal documents that stacks up. to him, because otherwise he'll say, no, it's not allowed in court. You go into court. When those marshals went into court and they just threw their paper sideways. But when they saw mine, they shut their mouth and changed their mind. Yeah, because I had the seal of King William and the flag and everything to go with the documents. Yeah, and a fair measure of real estate, because I've been in real estate, to know what that's about, and banking. Now I'm set up the bank already, the Maui Powerhouse Bank in London. I've got a company over there now, and a secretary there running that, and a political party, the Maui King William Party over there, right now. Ready to go. Right? Straight into Westminster. As soon as I go there with Kingi, we're in Westminster. Yeah, no, it's not. No, the Akaroa Bank is gobbled up. It's gobbled up in the BNZ and gone through the went through the League of Nations to the United Nations. The United Nations took over from the League of Nations, from the BNZ, and it was bankrupted here. The Akaroa was bankrupted here. So it's got no, there's no bank to show it. There's no one doing it. So I open up a new one. The Maui King William Party, political party, and the Maui Powerhouse Bank goes around the world where the flag went. Yes, totally new. I'm taking over the Bank of England. I'm telling everybody, I'm taking over. As soon as I get there, I'll take it over. Because the Pope and the Rothschilds got their authority from King William. Everyone got their authority. America, the whole Canada, New Zealand, Australia, got it from King William, from their flag. Everything came out of that flag. That's the only bank flag in the world. Nobody knows that. They don't know. How that works. The Admiralty is a bank. The Admiralty is a mortgage lien. The Admiralty is the instrument. It's already started. It's already, the war has already started. It's going now nuclear soon. They're banging each other up at the moment. All about money. To take over, because the Rothschilds want Syria, and so they want them to buy their pound note. So I'm coming with this pound note to take them out. the flag we got is very powerful if you know how to use it. That nobody can use it because they can't talk for the king. Only me. A woman can't talk for the king. I got to talk for the king because King let me. To talk. That sort of authority, to like a surrogate. So I'm like I've got my captain of my ship, but I got no ship. But I'm saying, on the documents, to make the documents authenticated. Yeah, on the Facebook and. The agenda is there. You can go to the YouTube. The agenda is on the YouTube for the Navy. You can see me talking to the Navy and the consent and the agenda for what's going to happen on the 28th. So I'm expecting the Navy to be there to assist to put the flag up to take the authority from Britain to the chiefs back to where it was square one when they first got here. Now when we get there, we go straight into the Waitangi Marae, like how we did on the 15th of April. Georgie was there, and so we did the karakias and everything there to open that marae up for King's Bench Court. It's now our King's native King's Bench Court, not a Queen's Bench Court, King's Bench Court. That's where they come to bits now, because after I did that, they start losing. Because it's authenticated. We've authenticated the flag to make it legal, and authenticated the marae to make it a King's Bench Court. Because it belongs to the native landowners. Right? We seize it. We seize it. And so we can go in there anytime. That's why the marae, the native, the Waitangi National Trust, the government said, we can't stop you, John. So it went, eh? What's that? Yeah, the whole lot of them. Yeah, they got no power. They haven't got the documents I've got. I'll take them to court and they'll lose. They cannot refute the titles I'm holding there, the Ututaonga title to the land, with one house in the whole of Bay Islands. I've got it here. Hare Ututaonga gave to me and to keep till we get the land back. And I've got the Manukau title here. The two titles to this whole country. Two titles. Two memorials. The Maui statue on East Island, that's Tahitian, and King William title. Those two titles. The Queen took the Maui statue and put it in London, and they put the Maui statue down in Dunedin with the hat on his head, that's the crown, and the other one in Auckland. See, that the Mana Whenua title, those two titles, they can't refute it. They got nothing. They got absolutely nothing to, against what I've got. You don't have to... Yeah, no, they know that. The people starting to wake up now. But the thing is, the memorial is we're all the same. The indigenous world is waiting for this. The indigenous countries are waiting for this flag to save them at the last minute before the nuclear bomb goes off. Right? You only got 1 month left. Well, next month, it's all over. Boom. Nuclear goes bang, 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 and already the sea's killing all of the fish with the Fukushima. It's the elite people doing that with all the money and the Pope and all the rest of them. Hillary Clinton and all the rest of those thugs. And this flag will kill all the thugs. All we have to do is make it legal, authenticate it, swear to each other. And I said to Willie Pato and them and Hohepa's lot, they rang me today and they said, oh, John, we understand what you're saying, because I'm going up to a hui next Wednesday up at Otawa in Hokianga to tell them what to do. For the first time, Ngāpū is listening to what I'm trying to be saying for a long, long time. You know, do it like this. Just go straight to Britain, forget about John Key. They'll follow suit. The debtors, anyway. He's over here, still in his place with Tracy, but they sort of glide past each other. They're still in Mangere, same place. Yeah, still in where they've been staying in their house, but sometimes he's there and sometimes he's not. But he's working in this radio station. He's down in South Island at the moment, waiting for him to come back, so we're going to sit down and have another meeting. Right? Yeah, no, that's normal. Yeah, that's normal. But so long as she came around here about 4 weeks ago, but she's all right. So long as I've been looking after my health and I've been going to the gym to keep fit and so that I don't pack up and with all the stress. You have your place and. They'll respect that, and that's why I said the Ngāpū and everybody else, they can't talk for the Confederation as well as you can, put it that way. And I'm not going to allow any of them to jump the queue, because that's what Hohepa was trying to do, jump the queue and with the taumata and make the taumata tell me what to do and sort of, you know. I've only known him from last year. It's because he's been in Australia, and to come back. But he can talk for his land in Matari Bay, but not on Kingi's land, eh? Yeah, that's the Ngāpū Nui Tonu, the Whakamininga. The eight tribes, Mohi said, the eight tribes. That's the one Nuki and the Mai, and they've always been trying to make another house. Yeah, they've been. That's a collective, but I'm only looking after Kingi on his land. My only concern is the commercial contract and the piece of land that they landed on. The first lot of people landed on from Britain. You can forget about everything else. And I'm not using Te Ture Whenua Act, I'm not using News and Law, I'm using the land laws of England in 1830 or 1837, so I can use a rope to hang them. Yeah, I'm going back to square one, square one. Yeah, yeah, you can turn up there after lunch or something like that in the afternoon, you know, take your time to get there. But, yeah, 26, that's when the Titi Marae opens. How are you going up? How are you going up? Oh, it's a long way to travel. I wish you could get a flight. I wish you had a flight to get up there, and then I'll pick you up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's too much to drive, too far. I find it very difficult driving even down the coast. Him and I had a fallout. I had a fallout with him on the heading of blocks out Port Awanui. Yeah, because of his nephew, the other fellow Atkins. He went and upset Painga's son, Eru Painga's son, and me. Yeah, and me on the marae, on Te Horo Marae. Yeah, and Desmond was right out of it. I think he'd been on the drugs again, on the smoke. And I always warned him, don't you ever do that in front of me, and he did. So that was the end of it. I've crossed them out of the way now. I'll go on my own. I said to him, no more. I'm going to go on my own. So now I'll do everything by myself. Yeah. No. It's not like that. It'll still be like normal. But the thing is, I don't know anybody else that can talk in the place of the original confederation where you're involved, and the Maori government. The Maori government is very important because they've got nothing. They did nothing. You need that in that marae. You need to stamp your mark in history and time, and I give it to you. I give that much respect to you for that part with Kingi. Yeah, if the trip will be worth it to be there to witness what's going to happen. I'll know from the Navy next week. The what? Oh, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because it's already set up to go, and that can wait later, because at the moment we just want to get the flag up and to swear to each other inside that whare, and to continue to trade with each other, to work with each other. Otherwise, it won't work without the link. And I've set up the other government in England just in case, because all it does is overarches all the Commonwealth in the world, including New Zealand. So there's nobody can change because it's coming from Westminster. I didn't upset them, but because they're going along with what I'm saying, but I'm including them in it. But it's what I'm trying to stop protesting things. To upset it all, what's been set up, because they had intentions of shifting the Waitangi Day into the marae over there instead of Titi and cut Titi out altogether. So I said to Kingi, you might as well give up and go on the other side and do it all over there. And so this is the chance to do it and do everything over there in that marae because it's yours. I said to him, it's your place and your land to say what you want to say once you go and put the flag up, and that's the end of that. Yeah. So we get past that. It's historic because now you can start talking, and they're going to have to listen to you. John Key and them will be limited on their what they can do. It's better to keep them there for debtors. If you took them out and told them to sack them, you get nothing. You haven't got the titles, your own land titles, to replace what they've got. Those are copyright to them. Everything with the word Maori on it, Maori Land Court, Maori this, Maori that, and all their documents with Te Tira and food belongs to the John Key. Everything. That's why I've gone right out of here and not used any of it. Not even the UCC laws and all those laws in the courts. I don't use those. I use only British ones from 1830 to 1837. Okay. I'll keep in touch with you in any developments next week. With the Navy, just to make sure. Okay? With the agenda, you can get it from Georgie, because she's picking everything offline. And Georgie's she's talking to me online all the time, on Facebook. So we're keeping in touch with her and you, and you can communicate with her and get what you want for what I'm saying from her. So you can keep your organization together. Yeah, I know. What I'm saying is, it's got to make it work this time to make a stand and to authenticate it all, so that the Crown will listen and anybody else is going to listen and take notice. And from that, revenue should flow. Yeah. Yeah, our own people have got different views. They don't understand because it's a bit far-fetched. All these banking things and all their mortgages and land and all title and all those things. It's too much. It's give up. And the laws have been made to confuse everybody. Too many laws. Okay. Okay, so thank you. Bye. Well, there we are. That's Sue Nikora. Finally, I got it. Finally, I get a bit on. We lost about 15 minutes when she first came on because I didn't have the camera ready. However, we've got her online. That's Sue Nikora, the Maori government prime minister. And that's her business. It's not with me, and she's in the Confederation, okay, the original Confederation of Chiefs. There's some others I haven't named in Ngāpuhi, the older ones I'm talking about, the originals, the ones that have been in over 20 years like me, and Sue's been in there just as long, or longer, being older, so she fits into the cog. And Willie Pater rang me tonight from Otawa, Marae, up that area in Hokianga, just to check with me coming up next Wednesday, 10 o'clock, to hui starts for the whakamininga in Otawa, Marae, in Hokianga, up from where? Oh, I forget now. But anyway, Kawakawa, through Kawakawa, and carry on going up that way, not to Kerikeri, the other way, straight on, Kerikeri that way, and that way to Hokianga, Otawa, before you get to Hokianga. Okay, so I'm glad I talked to Sue, Auntie Sue, and she's not up to this sort of banking part of commercial contracts, although she knows, but to physically be involved and to talk on a king's level. No, she's on the queen's side, and the documents that she has for the Maori government is totally inside the system. It's not on the king's side in the international arena.
of the Commonwealth countries that is just set. And the Queen has gone around there with our flag authority, Admiralty. Okay? That's why I'm telling her things. That when I tell these old people, they grab it and do things that they will never be able to link it up. They're best to stay in their professions. Sue is proficient in politics. She's the best there is. She's good at tikanga, whakapapa, land, how titles work on top of land, and how to administer a government better than John Key. She'll run rings around him because being major. But when it comes to the Pākehā world, or the British world and commerce, that's a different story because you've got to be able to handle a lot of other people and ethnicities and cultures at the same time. And I'm just one for watching the banking and the money side to make sure it doesn't go one way and not advantage everybody else. Like Clinton takes it all for her instead of going to Haiti for the fundraising and all that money they raise for devastated countries they bombed, it goes into her pocket for their elite families. They're caught now. I've just been reading it online. They've been caught out by Julian Assange and WikiLeaks and a few others that have dropped all the emails that she scrubbed and bleached out. And the FBI, like the CIB here, the police, lost the case against me. They're the same, no different from the FBI. Fraudulent and corrupted. To hell and back again. That's how I'm talking online. So, Sue, even though I could do a lot in her absence, I still think of her as fighting this long, long battle to get what she wants, the land back. And she's been to the United Nations more than once and been there with Jeffrey Palmer. So Jeffrey Palmer and the Labour Party is Maori policy maker, the native land Maori policy maker. Okay, so she's very important to me as any land information. But when it comes to stringing together the mortgage documents, the bank, and all the legal instruments with the king, far from it. Different kettle of fish. She's in the Queen's will. All her documents, the Maori government and the John Key's government, is in the same paddock field. Although she can pull it into the hapū field, she still needed the money from somewhere. I've created our own Moai pound note and Moai gold coin, King William's gold coins, currency online, in readiness for the first debtor instruments on Cook Street. Okay, so that's the case one against the police, and they'll go for escape once we authenticate everything. Again, we authenticated all our documents for Cook Street on the 15th of April of this year, 2016, to enforce the acts of Maui Crown King William, Commonwealth Governor of the World, on these lands. Okay? No influence on from this government or the Maori government. She has her government for the land here. We have a government to overarch it as an insurance against any outside forces. We're using the military from Britain as our partner. And the Navy there in Westminster. Parliament, you are our partners, and everything you see online that I do is between us and King William and Kingi Taurua, Chief one chief, that's all it takes, one chief, and me, land commissioner, native land commissioner, sheriff, and the judge in the court, whatever, to push the case. Okay, so to sue, I'm hoping that you come there and take your place. Otherwise, it leaves that out and the Maori will step in and fill the place. It's there anyway. It belongs to the people of the world, and including Ngāpui and Tainui, Ngāti Porou, Tahitians, anybody that's Tahitian, the Maui is your original title, mana whenua title to the land. Standing in London is there, that's our title there. And that's where we go to, you'll guide us there. Okay, so, Willie, if you're watching this video, Willie Peter, and whoever, there we are. And there she is. She'll back in behind the whakaminina as a woman, half and half a say in the matter. And she's with her sparring partner in politics, Kingi Taurua. Kingi Taurua is doing an excellent job of looking after the Crown Corporation side of the Queen, Elizabeth and Queen Victoria, and King Edward side of the commerce and revenue. And I'm looking after this side with King William, straight to Westminster, Parliament, government, military. Okay, so that's how that works. Anyway, I had to cut short going to the gym today and come back home to answer to a text from the Navy. So I got an answer back from John Harrison, and I'll hear back from all those people in the Navy to let me know who's coming to the this historic 182-year celebration at Waitangi on the treaty grounds. Okay, the idea there, I told Sue, was to bring everybody from Te Tiki Marae into that marae for any national celebration days, like the Waitangi Day in Waitangi Marae and the Confederation Day in the Waitangi Marae on the 28th and the 10th of April 2017 next year, and the 28th of October 2016 this year. It's Friday, 5 in the morning on the Waitangi Marae. So I'm hoping to get the right people to be speaking and to have their say in respect of the older people than me that I've associated with, learned from, and exchanged glances and answers and way forward. So Kingi is all that's left to see. I'm hoping he'll be back tomorrow and we can sit down and talk about this. He's got his own views. He's allowed to say what he says, but I respect him because he's a war veteran. He has every right to speak to the military, the Navy, here and in Britain. He's been more prominent to be in Britain with me to convey to the British military and Westminster with me that we are the partners that are going there, as male to male, king to king. He's a king in his own right, under the King Edward, to go there with me. on the Queen Victoria side, to Queen Victoria Trust there, to audit the books. Okay? I need him there to audit the books. I'm there as a land commissioner here to audit the books here in John Key's government and his treasury, and go to England and audit the HM Treasury in England too, with this flag. We have the right to do that as contract partners. And no one can change that. Only Kingi and I can go there and change that. We don't need anybody else. We just need to tell the rest of the hapu here, not iwi, the hapu, what our intentions are to go there. Too late now. The world, nuclear world war has started. It's starting soon. The war has already started. I told you, the bombs are going off. Just because of banks. Okay, so that's all I want to say. I better get some rest because I'm so tired from the gym. And I went up early today and cut short. Never mind. I'd miss out on that, finishing that and my swim. Now I shall rest and leave it at that. I'll upload this down to YouTube and it'll go out like that. You've heard her voice. Soon, Nikora, she'll be about a good 78 now, and still strong. Strong woman, and very knowledgeable. On politics, she knows everything back to front, and run rings around the Maryland court here, because she's doing the Ngāti Porou treaty claims, and I don't know how far she's got with that. But I'm saying, I'm separating, Kingi, you're watching the video, I'm separating the whakamininga from the incorporations, from the Maori government, from the Moai Commonwealth Government of the World, Federation, State, Government of the World. Okay, the Moai, Crown, Federal State, Commonwealth Government of the World. There. It's supposed to have King William IV in it, but I've just shortened it out. And that's where it comes from, King William. So there we are. We've got our systems in place around the world, set up in 250 countries. Now, all I'm going to do is to authenticate the Confederation inside that whare, because we did the whakamininga the last time, on the 15th, from Kororareka and Jim Wickerton, that side. And now we're doing the Confederation and the incorporations and the Maori government and the Mokopuna women. They'll be in there too, because that's their day. But this is the first time they'll be going into Waitangi Marae. We only had a small bunch in there on the 15th with Kingi and myself, and Hoepa, Epiha, and Willy Pater. You see? That was the elders, and us, the other. Elf Mitchell, and myself in the Confederation, with the Rangitiras there, and Peyton, the other guy. Nelson Painter, he was there. He's with us as well. Okay, so he's very knowledgeable alongside me and Elf. And who else was there? But those are the ones I've been associated for years. So they'll be in there, but I don't want too many people talking. I just only want Kingi, Jim Wikotu, Sue Nikora, Willy Pater, and that's it, and myself, in the Navy. That's it. There's not much time for anything else. We're only there to authenticate our documents and raise the flag and make resolutions or whatever they want to do in there. but we'll do that before we go in there. On to Te Marae, on the 26th and 27th. So that's really everything Kingi I can think of. Apart from that, that's your piece of land that they parked their ship on. Okay, where they parked their ship of Admiralty is the mortgage land contract. Okay, 1835 contract. The other one in Kororau Lake, 1834 contract, private, nobody's business. It's nobody, there's a lot of time to tell Sue. This is not anybody's business. This is our own business and the Navy. The Royal New Zealand Navy and the British Navy. Okay? To the King. To the King. That's where the Admiralty came from, not the Queen. She wasn't a sailor. It was King William the Fourth, sailor boy. That's our partner. Okay, got that? And what else about his staff? I think that's about it. That's about it, Kingi. I hope to see you tomorrow. Bye for now. It's on Wanoa today. It's Friday, 10:30 p.m. the 14th of October, 2016. That's all. I've opened one of the other websites on Facebook. Now the John Wanoa blog. On that site, John Wanoa blog, I'll be putting the latest of what we're doing up away from my main website, for John Wanoa, main website, on Facebook. So that's where I'll be concentrating a lot of my time now, on that site, with what's happening from now past, up to the 28th and past the 28th. Any questions or anybody wants to ask, put it there. But I might be able to do it straight away, or when I can, I'll answer it. Okay, thank you.